Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to make a cross-platform Blazor desktop app which shares code between the web version and the native Windows version, which is pretty cool, including how to do native interop, like this. Right, let's open up Visual Studio 2022. And we will create a new project. We'll find Blazor. Okay, we have a Blazor server app, which is pretty cool. We will do next. Let's call this cross-platform Blazor. Next. dotnet 6 preview. Create. And then we should have a web browser cross-platform Blazor app. There you go, look, it's a typical Blazor template with click me and so on, which is pretty fancy. All right, so we close that. Now we want to make a desktop version of this app. So the first thing we're going to do is add new project, do WinForms. We need to use the .NET Core version of this rather than .NET Framework. Next, WinForms Blazor. Yep. And we can quickly run this app. So, typical WinForms app there. So we want all of this stuff to be usable from also the WinForms app. So we need to move it out into a separate Razor class library. So what we can do there is create new project, Blazor class library, like share. Next, Blazor class library. Yep, like so. So we have a class library at the top. We need to add some NuGet packages. And we've already installed this guy. That's pretty useful. Okay, so you will need to have installed Microsoft ASP.NET Core Components Web in there. That appears to have automatically been added. Okay, interestingly, by creating the Razor class library, it has already created a Blazor class library by default, which has set up the NuGet packages for us, which is very useful. So all we then need to do is take our pages over there. We can delete them from the original. Move our shared stuff over there, delete them from the original. And if we add a reference to the shared library, we should be able to run this. Ah, okay. So we're missing some frameworks here. If we head into the project file, and we need to add a framework reference to ASP.NET Core, which looks a little bit like this, Razor support for MVC. Let's put this in here. Okay, very good. So that's fixed up the class library. Fewer errors, which is nice. So we're missing our weather forecast service. So what we can do, we can just drag that over there because that's shared code, like so. We can delete the original. And the iLogger is in extensions logging. Very nice. So we need to fix this reference that we've copied over, which is app is missing. So we need to move app over to Blazor class library. Very nice. And we'll also move imports over these guys. Okay, let's rebuild using Blazor class library, using Blazor class library dot shared. Rebuild. There you go. And now we have the Blazor code loading from the shared class library, which is step one complete. We're missing one more thing though, and that is moving the static assets over to the shared class library. So take the www root folder, paste it in the class library, merge it all. It's very nice. And then in the host, we need to change. So to fix the CSS, now that we've moved the Bootstrap references over to www root here in the class library, we need to put in content slash Blazor class library, like so. Now if we run the app, even the styles have been brought through from the shared library, although we're missing some icons and the fonts are strange, which is very odd. So, so we also need to do this to reference the site CSS. We run the app again. Very good. So now we've moved our entire app to the class library, which is pretty cool. Like so. So that is step one complete. Now we need to make the Windows Forms app run Blazor. We need to look for the Microsoft ASP.NET Core Components WebView Windows Forms NuGet package. Install this guy. Okay. Okay. So in the designer, we're going to have to manually, in the design backend designer code, we're going to need to manually add this because it's not showing up in the toolbox. So all the code for this is linked to in the description, but we will start creating our code here to manually add the Blazor web view, like so. So on the code behind for form one, we will paste this stuff in, like so. We will re-add app state later, so stick around for that. In weather forecast service, we want to refer to that one in the shared library. So for the WinForms Blazor app, one of the only things that we can't share is the root file. So here's one I made earlier. In www.root, we have just an index.html, and this is very, very similar to this host page in Pages. However, this is a pure HTML version of it. And it needs to WinForms Blazor for the inbuilt styles. So we also then need to add the Blazor WebView 1 to the controls on the form, or it won't render at all. We also need to make sure that the www.root folder is actually moving over. So for that, we need an item group that looks a little bit like this, and we can run WinForms Blazor. We need to update the project SDK to sdk.blazor as well, like so. Otherwise, the www.root stuff won't copy over. There you have it. Just about. We can fix this up. Look at that. So there we have it. This is the same code. Let's get rid of that border, make it really look basically cross-platformy. Okay, cool. Very good. One cross-platform Blazor app. Right-click on cross-platform. Debug. Start new instance. There you go. And we have a web version and the desktop version. Sharing the code, which is pretty cool. Next up, let's do some interop. So this is the classic click me counter. But we want to show this value natively in a native Windows UI. So we will stop that there. Form one, we will create a button. Shall we get a button? Wow, this brings me back. Button. There you go, look at that. Button one click. Whew, that's a good function name. But we will leave it for nostalgic purposes. Let's change the button to click me to show counter, like so. See? Click me to show counter. Very nice. G'day. Right, so we need an object to store the state of this. So in data, we'll just do add class app state, like so. Public class, public int counter, like that. And in here, we want to make it so that on the counter page, we will inject a instance of the app state. Okay, right. And we'll also do app state dot counter plus plus. Okay. In cross-platform Blazor, we will want to add this as a singleton. App state. Like so. In the web version, and over on the WinForms version, we will also, in the code behind for the form, so app state, we will move this to a static variable here somewhere. App state equals new app state. App state, plug that in there. Button one click, we will do message box dot show counter value app state dot counter, like show, run the app, go to counter, click it a few times, and then go for the native interop, which says counter value 6. Now there's loads of cool stuff you could probably do with this, like have the Blazor app pop up notifications and all sorts of native Windows cool stuff. If you thought that was useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. Very much appreciated. Until next time, thank you.